So we continue with exercise 18A and we are on the last sum of that thing. I don't know why I did this thing. I could have easily continued in the previous video itself so that I could have completed the exercise. But I don't know. I didn't see that it was only the last sum. Anyways, doesn't matter. We will continue with this thing on sum number 23. So that's the sum number 23. You got the circle and you got a point P, which is going to give you two tangents from here. Okay, and then you have got this line like this, this line like this, this line over here like this, connected to this over here, and then from the center like this. So this is A, B, O, C, P. Yeah, given that AOB is 140 degrees, this is 140 degrees, and they are given that APC is 80 degrees, this is 80 degrees. You need to find out BAC, that is angle BAC. This angle is what you need to find out. Okay. Okay, you can see that. Let's first solve it and then write it. AP and AC, PC are the two tangents. So we know that these two are equal. If this is 80, then automatically this over here will be 50 and this over here will be 50. Okay. And the next thing is, I know that, okay, you have this and this are equal, so this will be, this part will be 20 and this part will be 20. And I also know that this is the radius and this is the tangent, so this part is 90. Okay, so if this is 50, this is 90, so this part will be 40. 40 plus 20 is 60. So angle BAC will be 60. Okay, let's write it down. I'll explain again one by one. AP is equals to PC tangents from outside circle. Therefore, angle PAC is equals to angle PCA is equals to X, isosceles triangle. So X plus 80 is equals to 180 degrees. Sum of angles of triangle. Therefore 2X is equals to 100, X is equals to 50 degrees. Next we have that angle. So we have therefore angle PAC is equals to 50 degrees. Next, we have got angle OAP is equals to 90 degrees, tangent property. Therefore, angle OAC is equals to 90 minus 50 is equals to 40 degrees. Because this is 90 and this is 50, so this will be 40. Now, OA is equals to OP radii. Therefore, angle OAB is equals to angle OBA is equals to Y, isosceles triangle. Therefore, Y plus 140 is equals to 180 degrees. Sum of angles of triangle. Therefore, 2y is equals to 40 and y is equals to 20. Therefore, angle BAO is equals to 20 degrees. Therefore, angle BAC is equals to angle BAO plus angle OAC is equals to 20 plus 40 is equals to 60 degrees. So that was sum number 23 of exercise 18A. Okay, exercise 18A, sum number 23 is 60 degrees. So this was about the first exercise, that was 18A, which was over here for tangents. Now we see the next part of the chapter, that is intersecting chords. So we are going to have the properties of intersecting chords in the next theorem. So there are three more theorems to be understood. So in fact, two theorems and three theorems. Yeah, three theorems are there. But in this particular part, we'll be using one particular thing, and that is called as a similarity. Now we are going to use similarity of triangles, which is actually a chapter before circles. We have not done that thing. So what I'll do is that I'll just explain you in short about it, so that you are understanding the theorem of circles for this part. So whatever is important in this part is, I'll just explain you that thing. So let's understand first the similarity, and then we'll come to the theorem 12. So similarity means when two circles, when two objects, or we can say that when two shapes are same, if two diagrams are same shape but different sizes, then the two shapes are said to be similar. Like for example, if I take a small India ka map, which is pocket sized, and another which is a huge A4 size India ka map, both the maps have the same shape but they are different in sizes. Only thing is that one is enlarged. Okay, so when such a thing is there, we say that the two maps are similar to each other. Okay, that is what is similarity. In case of triangles also, two triangles will be similar. So if this is one triangle and this is another triangle, if it is such that this is an isosceles triangle and this is also an isosceles triangle, then both the triangles are similar because they are isosceles. भले ये 1-1 centimeter का है, ये 5-5 centimeter का है, फिर भी दोनों triangle का shape same है, इसीलिए they both are similar. So whenever you are proving the triangles to be similar, you are going to prove it by test of similarity, and the test of similarity are three. One is AA test, second is SSS test, and other is SAS test. A test. See, you can see over here, these are equilateral triangles. So you know, if this is 60, this is 60. So this is 60 and this is 60. If two angles of the triangle are same, third angle is automatically same. That's why we do not have AAA test. You have got only AA test. So if you are proving that in two triangles, if the two angles are equal, then automatically the two triangles are similar. So if we have got a triangle over here, like if this is one triangle and this is another triangle over here like this, and if it is given that this is 50 and this is 50, this is 70 and this is 70, then automatically this triangle is similar to this triangle by AA test. Okay, so if two angles of the two triangles, okay, two corresponding angles of the two triangles are equal, then the two triangles are said to be similar. And once the triangles are similar, it will be seen that the ratios of their sides will be equal. What do you mean by the ratio of the sides? Suppose this is A, B, C and this is P, Q, R, then it will be seen over here. Now this is not an equal, suppose we're not talking, okay, we'll just take this one. This is the isosceles triangle, this is A, B, C and this is P, Q, R. If these two triangles are similar, then it will be seen that by, जैसे अपने CPCT है congruent triangles में, वैसे यहाँ पे CSST है, corresponding sides of similar triangles. Okay, so it is going to be this way, that if triangle ABC is similar, this is a sign of similarity, triangle PQR, then it will be such that AB upon PQ will be equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. This is by CSST, corresponding sides of similar triangles. Okay, corresponding sides of similar triangles. Anyway, when you are learning the similarity chapter, you are going to go in detail. Yet now I'm just going to tell you in short that what is required. So if these two triangles are similar, it will be this way that agar ye side 1 hai aur ye side agar 5 hai, to agar ye 2 rahega to ye 10 rahega aur ye agar 3 hai to ye 15 rahega. Okay, so it will be such that AB upon PQ will be 1 upon 5. Then BC upon QR will also be 2 upon 10. There is nothing but 1 upon 5. And AC upon PR will be 3 upon 15. So again 1 upon 5. So the ratios of the sides will be equal. So in similar triangles, you find that the ratios of the sides are equal. This is what we are going to use to prove our next theorem. The next theorem what we are having is about intersecting chords. Okay, when the chords intersect each other externally or internally, then what is happening over there is what we are going to see in our next theorem, which is going to be proved using this particular property or this particular method of similarity. So let's start. So you have over here the first theorem. So the first theorem is about circle and intersecting chords, which is one chord like this and another chord like this. So this is chord AB and this is chord CD, intersecting at point P. Okay. What we prove over here is that AP into PB is equals to PC into PD. PA into PB is equals to PC into PD. PA into PB is equals to PC into PD. That is what you are going to prove. Okay, this is the theorem. The theorem states that if two chords of a circle intersect internally or externally, then the product of the lengths of the segments is equal. This is the length of the segment. This is one segment, this is a segment. So product of the lengths of the segments will be equal. PA into PB will be equal to PC into PD. This is what we are going to prove. So let's see. So we draw two triangles here, one layer and another here. So we have over here in triangle ACP and triangle DBP. Okay, this triangle and this triangle. You can see over here that this angle is equal to this angle, vertically opposite angle. So angle APC is equal to angle BPD, vertically opposite angle. And we also know that AD arc subtends this angle as well as this angle. So these two angles are in the same segment. So angle ACP is equal to angle BDP, BBP, that is angles in same segment. Therefore, triangle ACP is similar to triangle DBP by AA test. I told you that if you are having only two angles equal, then automatically third is also equal. We don't need to prove that thing. So in similarity of triangles, the test what we are using is AA test. So this is the AA test what we are using over here. Once you have this test, then you can take the ratio of the sides. So the ratio of the sides what you are taking over here will be, we start with this thing, AP, so the first and the last, upon DP is equals to CP upon BP, We don't require AC and BP because they are not required over here. So we're not yet using it. Okay. This is by CSST, that is corresponding sides of similar triangles are proportional. Now cross multiply, you get over here AP into BP is equal to CP into DP. That is what you need to prove over here. Is it clear? Understood? This is your first theorem. Now for the same theorem, if it is going to be this way, then the two chords are intersecting externally like this. Okay? Then I am going to draw. So this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is P. So PA into BB is equal to BC into BD. This is what we want over here. So again, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to draw a line like this. So then I've got the same triangle. ACP. That is ACP. Another triangle is DBP. Now you can see over here, this angle will be equal to this angle. Why? Because this angle is this exterior cyclic quadrilateral ka exterior angle. So this is equal to this and P is common. Angle P is common. Instead of vertical opposite, it will be P common. And this are the exterior angles of a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, they will be equal. Hence, the two triangles are similar. Hence, this part and then hence this part. Clear? If you want, I will just write it. That in the triangle over here, this is the same thing. I just write over here, angle P is equal to angle P for this part. And secondly is angle ACD is equal to angle DBP because exterior angle of cyclic quadrilateral. This is common. So only this part and this part are the same. So you can see this is the same thing. PB aa sakta hai idhar. So this two is the same thing. Baki ka sab kuch same hi hai dono mein. So this was our theorem number 12, that is if two chords of a circle intersect externally or internally, then the product of their lengths of the segments are equal. Okay, therefore PA into PB is equal to PC into PD. Now we come to the very 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 most important kind of a theorem which is normally missed out by us while solving a sum. Because वो जब सम तभी देखते हैं तो हम लोगों को समझ में नहीं आता है कि ये पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मूला और पर्टिकुलर थियरम कैसे अप्लाई करना है. सो प्लीज़ बी वेरी अटेंटिव व्हेन आई एक्सप्लेनिंग यू दिस पर्टिकुलर थियरम. द थियरम इज कॉल्ड एज एंगल्स इन द ऑल्टरनेट सेगमेंट्स आर इक्वल. ओके, इट इज गोइंग टू बी अ द प्रूफ इज ऑल्सो नॉट सो ईजी, बट एट द सेम टाइम द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज दैट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड what are the two angles which are equal because they are not in the same segment, they are on different segments. So that is what we need to prove in this particular theorem. So let's take the theorem first. So first of all, let's understand the theorem. The theorem goes this way, that if this is a circle, if this is a chord, let's make it slightly bigger. If this is a chord and this is a tangent where this chord and the tangent intersect, so this is point A, this is P, this is Q, this is D. Now first understand the theorem and then I'll explain you the proof. The theorem states that the angle which is formed by this chord and the tangent. That is, we are talking about this angle over here. We are talking about angle BAQ. The tangent, the angle between the tangent and the chord. The tangent and the chord. The angle which is formed by the tangent and the chord will be equal to, what it will be equal to? Let's see this. If I take this chord forming any angle over here, then this angle over here, if this is X, this will be X. Suppose we take this as C. So it is that BAQ will be equal to angle BCA. That is, angle which is formed, or the angle which is there between the tangent and the chord, the tangent and the chord, the angle formed between the tangent and the chord is equal to the angle formed by the chord in the alternate segment. Okay, at the point of contact is equal to the angle in the alternate segment. What is the alternate segment over here? This is one segment. This was segment over here. This angle is in this segment. We are talking about the alternate segment. Yani yahan pe, ye jagah pe koi bhi angle form hoga. B, C, Q or B, P, Q banao. Ya toh main koi bhi banao. Jaise, I can make some few angles over here. I can make something like this. Or make something like this. Or make something like this. All these angles, this angle, this angle, this angle, all will be X. Got it? So the theorem states that this particular angle BAQ, this BAQ is formed between the chord and the tangent. The angle between the chord and the tangent. That angle is equal to the angle formed by this chord in the alternate segment. Is it clear? This is exactly what is to be proved over here. So now we need to take the proof of this thing. Now this proof is also slightly tricky, so it is almost like solving a sum. So what we'll do over here is we are going to take at this particular point from the center one radius, one diameter, and then we are going to join this with this. Okay, so we should know that even angle ARB is the same as this because they will be in the same segment. So वो बाद में देखेंगे, पहले हम लोग लेते हैं तो दिस वन. सो यू सी ओवर हियर कंस्ट्रक्ट डायमीटर ओ ए आर एंड जॉइन आर बी. दिस इज सो वी हैव ओवर हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. सो कंस्ट्रक्शन इज ड्रॉ डायमीटर ए ओ आर एंड जॉइन RB. Okay, now we know over here that angle RAQ is 90 degree because it's the tangent and the diameter. So diameter and the tangent will be 90 degrees. So that's why this will be 90 degrees. And also I know that angle, this over here, RBA, will also be 90 degrees. Okay, this is also 90 degrees because it's a semicircle. Now, if you see this triangle over here, if this is 90, this angle will be 90 minus X. So this automatically becomes X. That's it. Understand it once again. You know that this is a diameter, this is a tangent. So diameter and tangent are perpendicular to each other. So this is 90 degrees. You know that this is the diameter and this is the angle in the semicircle. Accordingly, this is going to be 90 degrees. If this is 90 degrees, so this RAB is a right angle triangle, such that if this angle over here is X, then this angle over here will be 90 minus X, because this is 90. Usme ye X hai, to ye 90 minus X hua. So this will be how much? 90 plus 90 minus X minus 180. So this will become X. So that means that if this is X, this is X and this is X, if this and this are going to be the same angle in the same segment, because both are formed by AB, hence this will be X, so this will be X. Clear? Let's write it down. We write over here first, angle RAB is equal to 90 degrees, tangent property. The next we have is angle RBA is equal to 90 degrees, angle in semicircle. If angle BAQ is equal to X, therefore angle BAR will be 90 minus X. Okay, this complete thing is 90. If this is X, this will be 90 minus X. So in triangle RBA, angle R plus angle B plus angle A is equal to 180 degrees. Sum of angles. Angle R will be plus B is 90 plus 90 minus X is equal to 180. So angle R is equal to 180 minus 90 minus 90 plus X. So that is going to be X. Therefore, angle BAQ is equal to angle BRA. BAQ is BRA. And angle BRA is equal to angle BCA, angle in same segment. Therefore, angle BAQ is equal to angle BCA. This is the proof of the thing over here, right? Clear? So angles in the opposite alternate segments are equal. Yeah, that's it. They are given something extra also, that is, if I am taking something over here, like if I take over here angle, then this angle will be equal to this angle. It's very simple. If this is X, this will be 180 minus X, and this is X, this will also be 180 minus X, because opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. So this is 180 minus X, this is also 180 minus X. Wo bhi prove kar diya. So that's an easy thing, not a problem. So this was about the theorem number 13, or third theorem in this part of the chapter. So that was that angle between the tangent and the chord through the point of contact is equal to an angle in the alternate segment. Very important, alternate segment. Yani kya? Angle formed by the tangent and the chord, ye wala angle, will be equal to the angle formed by this chord in this part of the segment. Okay, that is what is this particular one. Okay, so this was the theorem. We go to the next video and we see one more theorem, that is about the tangent and the chord, intersecting chord.